Welcome back out to the job site, and what I wanted to do today was go through or start a series of videos, three I think it'll end up being, on the materials we need to pour this concrete footpath. So I'm going to break it up into three videos. One will be perimeter for our formwork, second one will be area for our reinforcement, and the third one will be on volume for our to work out the actual concrete. So this will be the first one, which is going to be perimeter. So in order to form our mold for our concrete footpath, we need to have some formwork, generally timber, although you can use steel. A lot of the professionals use a steel product, but for the average builder, handyman, timber's cheaper and more readily available, so we'll generally use that. And obviously it goes around the perimeter of our slab, so the best method of calculation is to use perimeter. There's the formwork there by itself. So the best way to start a job or start working out something is always make a sketch. So sketch it out, it doesn't have to be to scale, put your dimensions on it. So this slab's 5 meters, 678 long, 800 mil wide and 75 mil thick for a footpath. So the first thing we need to do is work out the distance around the outside, which is perimeter, and the formula for perimeter is just the sum of all the sides. So if we work our way around, 5.678 plus 800 plus 5.678 for this side plus 800, add them all together, gives us a total length of 12.956 metres for our formwork around the outside of our slab. But if we go back and have a look at our formwork, you'll actually notice the formwork's longer than just that exact measurement of the slab. It runs past, and not only does it run past by the thickness of the formwork itself, so the thickness of this piece here and the same here on all sides, you can see I've set the formwork up in these pictures so that it runs past on each end, so I don't actually have to cut my formwork to an exact length. I can let it run past, and the less you have to cut formwork, the more reusable it is later on. So we always try and set it up so we can reuse our formwork. So yep, even though I have worked out the exact perimeter of my slab, then it's not going to be really enough for my formwork, so I have to allow a little bit more. Now the other thing is, over here in Australia, timber comes in standard lengths and usually increments of 0.3 or 300 millimeters, and depending on the timber yard, they might start at about 1.8, although generally 2.4 is about the shortest length the timber yard would stock, and run up to anywhere up to about 6 meters for natural timber. So we need to make our lengths of timber that we're going to buy work into these sizes. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to take my 5.678, and I could go up to 5.7, but that's really only another 22 mil long, and our timber, it's going to be a minimum 35 mil thick. So I'm going to round that up to 6 meters for my two long pieces on the edges. That'll let them run past a little bit. And my two ends, I can add 800 and 800 gives me 1.6. So I can round that up to my shortest length there, 1.8, to allow for my ends. So what I'm going to order from the timber yard would be two 6 metre lengths and one 1.8 metre length. So that gives me a total of 13.8 lineal metres of timber. And that's how they're going to charge me. They're going to give me a price per lineal metre of timber. So that's my timber worked out. That's my formwork for around the perimeter. You'll notice in the picture, but we have a few pegs to hold that into place. Now, the number of pegs you put in does differ depending on how thick your actual edge board is. The thicker the edge board, the less pegs you're going to need to have. But as a general rule, I like to put one in every 800 to a metre. And obviously you need to have a couple of extra ones in your corners, to hold both sides of the corner, just so the slab doesn't want to, or the formwork doesn't want to separate in the corners. So to work out our pegs, what we need is the length of our slab, or the length of our formwork, which we're working on 13.8, a peg spacing, which I'm going to say is 800, and then we need to add a couple, one extra peg for each corner. So I'm going to say there's an extra four pegs for the corners. So 13.8 divided by 0.8 gives us 17.25. Let's say 18 pegs plus 4 for the corners, and that gives us a total of 22 pegs for our job. So that's what we need to do in order to work out the formwork for our simple concrete footpath and the pegs that we need for it. So in the next video, what I'm going to do, I'm going to look at how we work out how much reinforcement we actually need to put the mesh or the reinforcement into this slab.